34 points out of their final 27 games to get to the postseason as Nico Dawes knocks one forward. Big hit, knocks Nate Bastian down. That was Matthew Rempe.
Penalty coming.
Holtz has it broken up, and now we see Rempe challenged by Siegenthaler.
I mean, I know he's a big, tough, strong kid and had to fight his first shift against the Islanders. And this is uncalled for. Really is. You know, he's getting a penalty for the hit on Bastian. We'll see how Nate is. Siegenthaler, you know, he's not going to. Just trying to protect his teammate and show that, you know, that was a bad hit, but he's not going to match up against the big Rempe, who's a tough kid.
Referees there, Michael Markovich and Francois St. Laurent, and they're still discussing this, whether it will be a two or a five. Ended up being a high hit. You could also say that it was likely charging there as Rempe had a big run up to it.
Well, if you look at his right arm, it looks like we call this a chicken wing. Look at that. Oh, maybe he kept it in, but
there are multiple penalties on the play.
But it's still a shoulder to the head. It's a shoulder to the head, Bryce.
All right, they're going
to
review a major penalty and also likely call multiple penalties here on Matt Rempe.
Now, let's not forget, he's a big kid, so he's going to have to, you know, be careful because contact. He kept his elbow down, no question, but contact, when he makes contact, a lot of time it's going to be with the head because of his size. He's a big boy.
6'8", Matthew Rempe, again, third NHL game.
I wonder if it's the shoulder that hits his head or his arm.
It's the shoulder.
He got a big run up all the way from the blue line. That's why I think that the charging major could also be something that they're reviewing here. And then Rempe and Siegenthaler came together, and Rempe threw a couple quick punches. I think he's drawing a penalty for that as well, as the official said there'd be multiple penalties here.
Well, Siegenthaler was, you know, just hooking him up ice, and obviously Rempe felt he was challenged, so he gets a few rights in. There's a look at the hit again. He plays right through Nate Bastian, but I don't know how they call this in general, Bill, because it is a shoulder, but does it matter if it's to the head? I never know, so we'll let the referees in the league decide on that.
Yeah, there was direct contact to the head, which imagine will factor in here. And again, I think you throw in the fact that Rempe came off the bench and basically without stopping went all the way from the Rangers bench to Bastian, who was in his own zone. That's where you possibly factor charging in here. They're taking a long look. Again, you can review major penalties. You cannot review minors. So if you're a referee and you're unsure, it makes sense to call the major, and then you can go back to the monitor and take a look.
Yeah, I'm really interested to see what they end up deciding on this one.
I think at minimum you're getting two minor penalties on Rempe. You could get a major penalty and a minor penalty as well.
I always come from the school, I know the game's evolved, that you want to get noticed out there. He's a big, tough kid. I get it. And he's got to finish his checks.
All right, here comes the decision.
Well, they're not sending him off.
What's going to transpire here?
Let's hear from Michael Markovich.
New York number 73 has a match penalty for head contact. Huh? Also a 2-minute minor for roughing. New Jersey 71 has a 2-minute minor for roughing. 5 minutes will go on the clock.
All right, so
power
you got
play for New Jersey.
Matching roughing penalties on Rempe and Siegenthaler. They'll both come off. And you've got Rempe with 5 plus the match penalty for head contact. His first experience of the Hudson River rivalry lasts 10 seconds before he is set off the ice.
He certainly got noticed because he had a scrap with Matt Martin, the veteran, who's been doing that for years, and then here his first shift against the Devils. He's gone. You spoke too early, Bill. He wasn't sure what the penalty was going to be either, so obviously they decide on a match penalty. But the Devils, the bottom line is you've got to get your power play going.
Yep.
Because it's all for naught. You've got to make them pay. And you've got a long advantage here. You got to get some goals, or at least one, to get it going.
Yeah, you have 5 minutes here to get things going and get yourself off on the right foot. Score early so you're not chasing the game. And again, to get this power play going, the Devils are just 4 for their last 57 on the man advantage. They will start with their usual 5 of Hughes, Heischer, Bratt, and Toffoli. Siegenthaler will sit for 2 minutes, but They'll play 5-on-4. He'll be released at the first whistle. After 2 minutes come off the clock, Will Cooley will serve Rempe's penalty.
You know, for Matt Rempe, he's going to be that big physical force for the Rangers. He's got some ability. I remember watching him